Learn how you can use Visual Studio to analyze your SQL scripts and tell you some best practices this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Erik. Erik, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, I help people run applications in Azure with custom development. And a part of that, they often use a SQL Server or as a SQL database. And I am also an MVP and provide tools for helping people make the most of Azure SQL database and SQL Server as a .NET developer.
Cool. Awesome. Yes. Well, we will absolutely put some links in the description for folks to go learn more about some of the things you work on. But getting right into today, like you wanted to talk about analyzing your SQL scripts in Visual Studio, and I'd love to learn a little bit more about what you mean and what you want to show us.
Yes. So I'm going to show how you can improve your SQL scripts and your database schema by running something called static code analysis. As a .NET developer, it's something that most .NET developers are quite familiar to because it's actually kind of built into Visual Studio and always running in the background and coming with suggestions about how you can improve your code. It's not a compilation that's causing errors or disabling you from actually building your code, but it's more kind of opinionated ideas about how you can improve your code by analyzing it in the background.
Cool.
And SQL Server Database Projects has a similar feature. It's not exactly running in the background, just like it is in Visual Studio, but it's static. And when you do a build with that feature enabled, you will get notifications about how you can improve your SQL scripts and your database schema.
Cool. Awesome. Well, that sounds great. I'd love to dive right in and take a look.
Cool. So I'm going to switch to Visual Studio, and I have created a database project here, and I have the data workload installed in Visual Studio, and that enabled to go to File, New Project, and create a database project, which is a project that holds my database schema and all my code that I want to run inside my database. And it will allow me to analyze all the code and ensure that everything is consistent. So like if I refer from one table to another in a foreign key or in my stored procedures, I will get build error if I refer to something that doesn't exist. So it ensures that all my objects are consistent, and I will get build errors if they're not. And the outcome of the build is a DACPAC, which is a piece of it's basically a zip file that you can take, and then you can apply that against your production database and say, now I have this schema. This is what I want my database to look like. Make it happen. So it's almost magic. So,
awesome.
And part of that, so we will try. I have added a kind of movie database with some screening table and a theater table. So we have a movies table with an ID and a title and a release date. I have tried a little bit of a quirky column name here just to see if I can break something. And I also have a poster where I'm using the image type. We have a screening of a movie, and it's pointing back to the movie table, of course. And a screening happens in a theater, so we also have a little theater table. And then I have a single stop procedure that allows me to get some screenings and movies based on a day. So now I will try to build this project. And you can see down here that this DACPAC file that I mentioned earlier is produced. And that DACPAC file, then you can take that and deploy against your database also via your continuous deployment pipeline and in Azure DevOps or GitHub, for example.
Awesome. Cool.
Right now, we're just building the project. So if, for example, I try to type anything here that, let me just see. Yeah, so if I do something like this, like call this something, and we have another foreign key referring to this ID in the screening table, you can see I already start to get errors here. And if I try to build the project, it will most likely fail. So this is the kind of consistency checking I mentioned earlier.
Awesome. And a question for you. So like, I'm guessing this is using like some base set of rules. Like, do we have any control if we want to use different rules, or we don't care about some rules, or are there scenarios like that?
Yes, there are scenarios where you can disable and enable rules. But right now I have not enabled any rules at all. So let's start by doing that. I go into the properties of the project, and right down here at the bottom, there's a tab called code analysis. So now I will check this mark and enable code analysis on build. And I have a number of rules enabled already. I will save the project, and then I will build again. You can see, we can check the error list. At the moment, there's no warnings. So we will build the project again. So now it's going past the phase of ensuring that our schema's integrity is okay, but then it's actually producing a number of warnings, telling us things like you should avoid using select star. So it's more, it's things you can do, but maybe in many instances you shouldn't do. This is what the static code analysis gives you. So it's, as I said before, it's opinionated, but it's made by Microsoft and other smart people that know what you should, or have good opinions about what you should and shouldn't do. So maybe you can adopt those rules. And by adopting those rules, maybe as a DBA, you can help your developers ensure that their SQL scripts and their tables are designed with high quality, with a high quality bar. So we can take these rules, reflect on them, and rephrase our schema to adhere to those rules. For example, in this table, I have used a very quirky column name, and it says don't use these special characters in columns names because it will make it painful for everybody. So let's get rid of these. And then it says, you don't use deprecated text in text and image data types. So I used an image data types here, and I should probably use var binary max. In reality, I probably shouldn't keep a poster image in my database at any rate. But let's fix it, see if we can fix it. So I have now tried to fix my schema. I will build the project again, and we will no longer see those issues that was mentioned before. There's still a number of issues to fix. So so that's basically using those rules.
Cool, this is awesome.
Database projects comes with a number of Microsoft created rules. And you can also add extra rules. I have published a couple of NuGet packages with some additional rules that you can apply to your Visual Studio installation and get even better, in my opinion, code analysis. You can see there's many, many, many rules here that you can apply and run against your database schema.
Awesome. That's great. And is it pretty easy to add rules? Like, for example, you mentioned you have a NuGet package that you released. Like, what if I wanted to add like a custom rule myself?
Yeah, you can do that. You need to be able to program in C#. And you need to have Visual Studio or at least Visual Studio Code so you can build a C# project.
Right.
But other than that, it's definitely possible. And I have published a blog post about how it can be done. So create a custom code analysis rule, what packages you should refer to in your library, and basically going through the motion of creating a file. That rule file is just a DLL file that you can then include in your project or add to Visual Studio, sorry. So.
Awesome. Oh, another question for you, Eric. Like, let's say I am leading a team, a dev team, and we're using this service. Yeah. And you know what? Instead of having warnings, we actually want this to error. Like, there are certain rules that we feel really strongly or really opinionated about. Like, is that something that I could do?
Easily, you can see there's a column here that says treat warning as error. So if we check this one with avoid select star, and then try to save that setting. It's only settings are saved as part of the project file and will be included in source control. So it will apply to anybody using this project. So we'll try to build again. And you can see now we got one error from this select star break thing we did here.
So, I see.
Yeah.
Awesome. So that's how you can kind of protect your database.
So then you can protect your database and you can actually do it very, very early in the process. Uh-huh. About so you as a DBA can say, I'm participating in the code reviews of this and I want to always have this this rule enforced, because I don't want anybody to, we don't want any select stars to sneak in anywhere.
Yes. Right. Yeah, no, I love that. Okay, I have two quick questions for you before we close out. One is, like, you're usually in Visual Studio. Yes. Do I need to have a license? And then my follow-up question was, like, does this work in places like Azure Data Studio or VS Code?
Yes. Regarding license, the SQL team has been negotiating with Visual Studio team, and in the license agreement for Visual Studio Community Edition, it says that even as an enterprise user, you are allowed to use this particular project type and some other SQL Server related project types for free for as many employees as you want.
Amazing.
Yes. And what was the follow-up question? Sorry,
the follow-up was, you know, if I want, I mean, this kind of answers it for me then, it's free here, but if I'm using VS Code or Azure Data Studio, can I get the same capability there?
Yes, it's possible. I have a blog post about how it can be done. It's not a really, really nice experience at the moment. I think I would imagine work is being done on it, because this capability has just been enabled like very, very recently. But it's possible to do that with the database projects, both in VS Code and in Azure Data Studio, which is based on VS Code. So yes, it's technically possible, and I have a blog post telling you how to do it. But it's not a streamlined experience. But even in Visual Studio, it's actually not. You have to put a DLL file in a place where you would normally not have write access when you if you're not an administrator on your machine. So even in Visual Studio, it's not 100% smooth. I am a contributor to a project called, let me just go to this one, called MSBuild.SDK.Sqlproj, that you can build in Visual Studio, which already includes all these rules, and it's very easy to add your own rules as well. And you don't need to go to any read-only folders and place stuff if you're using this SDK.
Cool. Awesome. Well, Eric, thanks so much for coming on the show. Personally, I learned a lot. I think our viewers probably did too. A lot of awesome references you referenced today. We'll make sure we get all of those in the description for our viewers. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like and leave us a comment and let us know what you think of this capability. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.